Tonight's episode of All Star Mr. and Mrs. was recorded before the death of Michael Jackson!
Calm down, Michael Buffer. You're only doing a brief continuity announcement.
Gentlemen, please welcome your hosts for tonight, Philip Schofield and Fern Britton.
Star Mr. and Mrs. the show where three bold celebrity couples roll up the rug of their relationship and let us see what's been swept underneath.
We will play good cop and even nicer cop as we interrogate them to discover precisely how much they know about each other.
So who are the couples playing All-Star Mr. and Mrs. tonight? Sugar Babe Keisha Buchanan and her boyfriend Dean. Former Liberal Party leader Lord David Steele and Lady Judy Steele. And actor Sean Williamson and his wife Melanie.
Each of them, of course, believe that they have found Mr. or Mrs. Right. But maybe later tonight they might discover they've found Mr. and Mrs. Wrong.
They're here to battle it out for their charity as they all want that £30,000 jackpot. So let's meet our first lovebirds to squawk the squawk. It's Sugar Babe Keisha Buchanan and her partner Dean Thomas.
Keisha and Dean have been going out for 2 years. Dean is also in show business, currently acting on stage in a musical. And they've recently bought a new house together.
Welcome! How lovely to see you. So, before we have a chat, let's find out what you said about each other.
Okay. Me and Dean have been together for nearly 2 years now.
We met through mutual friends at a dinner party.
He would say I was stuck up.
I thought she was a bit stuck up.
He's exaggerating.
It just felt like Casper the Ghost, like she just looked straight through me.
He was just cool. He was a really, really friendly guy, and I think that's what attracted me to him, I think.
I don't see her as a pop star. To me, she's just, you know, my little pint-sized hot chocolate.
People find this really weird about us, but we've been in the house, we won't see each other for 6 hours. We'll just text each other.
If she's downstairs and I'm upstairs, I'll sometimes give her a little text saying, are you okay?
But it's nice because it just gives you that space, and when you come together again, it's like, it keeps it fresh and new. Woo!
This girl is so competitive. It's absolutely ridiculous.
You were talking over it!
Shut up, I've got a feeling if she gets a question wrong, he's going to break out into a slight altercation.
We definitely want to win. I know that for a fact. But at the end of the day, we're still going to go home with each other, which is probably the best prize.
Oh, that's lovely. You don't need to win anything else now. You have each other to go home with.
Dean, you're a bit obsessive around the house, I understand.
Yes, I am. I have a mad obsession of hoovering.
Hoovering, he does. He'll go over my hoovering, I'll do it, and then you'll see him, like Mary Poppins, 10 seconds later, going over
Why?
All my stuff.
My mother raised me just to make sure every inch and corner of the house is clean, and if she does it, I have to kind of make sure I go over it, just for security, you know?
Really? So, yeah. And how long would it take you to, say, plump the cushions or the pillows on the bed?
Tell the truth.
Probably about 5 to 10 minutes, because I've got to make sure they're all in, arranged and everything, no creases on it.
He does.
So you've gone from sounding like the perfect guy to a bit of a nightmare here.
Thanks a lot.
If you're ready, it is time to play All-Star Mr. and Mrs. Let's move the booth. Ooh. Steady on. The rules are very simple. Both partners will be asked the same questions. All they have to do is to match the answers. So, to win the game, they simply have to say the same.
So, Dean, you're going to be the first one in the booth. We will ask Keisha three questions and then we'll bring Dean back and out of the booth and ask him the same three questions. And to win the game, their answers simply need to match. OK, question one.
Yes.
Which of these dates will Dean say you felt most excited about?
OK.
Is it the day you got your first number one album with the Sugar Babes?
Right.
Or the day you moved in together? Or maybe it was the day you got your love tattoo?
Oh, the love tattoo, this is mine here. I got this done and we were going to get matching tattoos anyway. He got his one done after I got mine and...
Should you have got them both together but you went ahead and did it on your own?
Yeah, no, I did and he won't let me live that down.
Okay, so which date will Dean say you felt most excited about?
Oh my God.
This is only question one.
I know. I think he might say it's maybe when we moved in together, but then he's going to be maybe between, because obviously his first Sugar Babe album going to number one is quite important, so I'll probably say Sugar Babe's number one.
Ooh.
And he's not going to say that.
He's not going to say that.
Never mind.
I don't think
you may have misunderstood the way the game works. Okay, question two.
Yes.
Dean has said that you never listen to him, but when would he have most liked your full attention?
Okay.
When he asked you to stop calling him Blinky.
Okay.
When he said he didn't want to dance in your music video.
Okay.
Or when he said, have you seen the price of that table?
Have you seen the price of that table?
Okay, so perhaps we ought to quickly have a run through what these are all about. Blinky?
Blinky, that he basically, when he watches TV, to me, he blinks more than the average person, quite a lot. And so that was where that name came from, yeah.
The one you went for, though, was the table.
OK, this is really silly of me, but I was in Harrods, and I saw a table which I really liked, and I thought the actual discount price was the price of the table.
The discount price was how much?
About £5,000. So basically, I got my card out, and then about within 50 seconds, there were so much people going, oh, and you go from Sugar Babes and all that, oh, what a lovely table. And then he takes the £5,000, and I'm like, great, so when is it going to be delivered? And he's like, when the second check comes in. And I'm like, how much is that? And he says, well, the whole £22,000.
So the reaction when you got home?
He was, I mean, he liked the table, but table, but he actually is quite, when it comes to saving money, he's really like full on. He likes to budget and he's good.
Fair enough.
Well, let's see what he says then, shall we?
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Last question. Question three. When Dean's out and about, he often picks you up lovely little presents. But what would you say is the worst present that Dean has ever bought you?
Oh, it's not the worst. I can't say it's the worst because I have to answer to him when I get home. But he was like, you know, babe, I've got this amazing thing for you when I get home. Just wait to see it. You're going to love it. And he pulls out this Aston Villa T-shirt, the hat, the mug, the gloves, everything. And I'm not really a big fan of football anyway, so I just kind of smiled and...
But he had personalised it for you as well.
Yes, he did. It said Blinky's Girl on the back.
Blinky's Girl.
Yeah.
And now you wear that all weekend, every weekend, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's get him out of the booth. Here we go. Dean, would you please leave the booth? Well done. Thank you.
Well, Dean, Keisha has given us her three answers. All you need to do is match what she has said, OK? Good luck.
Question one, Dean. Which of these dates do you think Keisha felt most excited about? Was it the day she got her love tattoo? Was it the day you moved in together? Or was it the day she got her first number one album with the Sugar Babes?
I know she loves music to bits, so I know that's a very big deal. The tattoos are also a big deal. I think it's probably the day we moved in together.
Oh, wow. She did wonder whether it might be that day, and then she went, no, he'll understand about the Sugar Babes album going to number one. Ooh, Keisha.
Hi.
Ooh.
You knew he was going to say
evils.
That. You knew he was going to say that. Here's question two. Good luck with this one. Now, you say that Keisha never listens to you. But when would you have most liked her full attention? When you said, have you seen the price of that table? When you asked her to stop calling you Blinky. Didn't know we knew that, did you? Or when you said you didn't want to dance in a music video, what did she say?
These questions are so hard. Because I always ask her for full attention, but I never get it, so... You're welcome, babe, anytime. I'd probably have to say the table.
Yes, absolutely. That's enough. The £22,000 dining table.
Yes.
Well done.
You are, although you might have thought that was blowing the budget, you are nonetheless very generous and you like to go out and buy little presents for Keisha. But what did she say was the worst present that you have ever bought her?
Oh, there's a worst present, was there?
Shh, don't ask her. No, I know they've all been absolutely top presents, but there might be one that was less top than the others.
Probably my favourite present that I got for her was an Aston Villa shirt.
Oh, yeah.
With a scarf and gloves. Mm-hmm. I've bought her... Oh, gosh. Now, I want to stick with that. Probably that one.
Final answer, Aston Villa kit.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right.
Well done.
Thank you. OK, at the end of that round, you got 2 matches out of 3, which is pretty good, and they will be back in a minute to play the his and hers round. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, it's Keisha and Dean. Well done.
After the break, when we'll be meeting Liberal Democrat Lord David Steele and his wife Judy, and Extras actor Sean Williamson and his wife Melanie, as they play All-Star Mr. and Mrs.
Coming up...
He pretended that he liked cats when we first got together because they used to sleep on the bed. Yeah, I had 9.
We know.
I thought there were only 7.
Good job you didn't ask that question, didn't you?
This is the show that pokes a stick into the beehive of domestic bliss and causes something of a buzz. Next to play, we have Lord Steele and Lady Steele.
Lord David Steele and his wife Judy met while they were at university to relax on an evening they like nothing more than a good home-cooked meal and a nice glass of wine.
Hi, David.
Is
nice
it all right if we call you David and Judy? Is that
certainly
all right?
Love people
that.
Use our names.
Yeah, good. That's a lucky one. So, before we have a chat, let's have a look at what you said about each other.
We've been married for 47 years.
Well, I first met Judy when she was selling the student newspaper in the university.
I was quite a wild young thing when I met David, and my mother was extremely relieved when I started going out with him.
I think I was regarded as the model son-in-law, but I'm not sure I liked that very much. Here's to us. Here's to us. I find the whole Lord and Lady thing actually quite embarrassing.
We certainly don't swan around as Lord and Lady anything.
I think we need to trim these trees.
We have a very bantering sort of relationship. I mean, we're quite rude to each other. It's a man's job to empty the compost bin, darling.
Oh, God. I think it's quite a good thing. It'd be awful to have a wife who was simply a sort of toady and agreed with everything you ever say. And certainly, there's no risk of that with Judy.
They're turning them up upside down.
I'm not turning them up upside down.
We spend quite a lot of time apart. Judy doesn't come to London very much.
I'm very based here in the Scottish borders. But I think it's given a strength to our marriage.
We're very lucky, I think. Our marriage is very fresh because of that.
That's lovely. Judy, you were quite disappointed when you first got married, weren't you?
Well, in some respect, not all of them.
Careful.
But there was one thing that I expected to happen in bed in the morning.
Really?
It didn't happen.
Really? What would that be?
Well, it was what my father always did for my mother in bed in the morning.
Right.
He always brought her a cup of tea before she got out of bed. And I thought that was what being married was about, but...
And so, when you finally got married...
I discovered it didn't happen.
And does it happen at all,
it
baby?
It happens on Sundays. Get
happens
it right.
on Sundays. Yes, happens There's a cup of coffee on Sundays, yes. yes.
Oh, well,
but you don't go around
right.
making the fires like my father did.
No.
Well, it is time now to play All-Star Mr and Mrs. And Judy, would you like to get yourself settled in the booth, please? Are you all right there? Well done. Very good. The rules are very simple. We ask you three questions, and all you have to do is match your answers with Judy's.
Simple.
Easy. David, question one. You still travel a great deal, and when you return from your many trips, what's the first thing you do when you get home? Is it turn on the computer? Is it give Judy a kiss and a cuddle? Or is it get out the fishing rod? Or perhaps you'd like to say something else?
I think she will say it's I turn on the computer. I will say I give her a kiss and a cuddle, but you better put down the computer.
Ah, now that's good political thinking.
Yes.
Here's a tricky question for you, because you and Judy, as we've seen, you live in the Scottish Borders. Obviously, you're exposed to the full force of nature there. Mm-hmm. So which of these weather fronts would Judy say best sums you up? Would it be a force 10 gale? Uncontrollable, but leaves a trail of destruction. Would it be thunder and lightning? Loud and exciting at first, but gets dull after a while. Would it be a blanket of snow? Looks beautiful in the early days, but as time goes on, becomes a bit slushy and dirty.
I'll go for the first one, the force 10 gale.
You're a force 10 gale. Happy with that?
Yes.
Yes,
we'll go for
okay.
That.
David, question three. You and Judy love to take part in motor rallies together. You are the driver,
yes.
Judy is the navigator.
Yes.
Rather a novice at it, or is she...
Very.
No. I'm beginning to see where we're going with this one. All right.
Wrong
so...
way.
So, imagine that Judy manages to get you totally lost
mm-hmm.
during a day out on a rally.
Right.
Would you not worry and have a good laugh about it? Or would you pull over into a lay-by and have a blazing row about her navigation? Or would you stop and begrudgingly ask for directions? Or would you kick her out at the local train station and zoom off on your own?
Number one.
Not worry and have a good laugh about it.
Yeah.
Very
okay.
nice. Yes.
Oh, popular
right answer.
Popular answer.
Very good.
Let's see whether that's what she says.
Well, quite. That could be difficult.
Let's get her up. Judy, would you please leave the booth? Oh, yes, you've been in there so long, we've had a couple of seasons since you've been here. Don't worry about it.
So remember, all you need to do is to match answers here.
Judy, David still travels a great deal for work, but when he returns home from one of his many trips, what does David say is the first thing he does? Is it get out the fishing rod? Is it turn on the computer? Is it give you a kiss and a cuddle? Or did he say something else?
I don't know what he said, but what he usually does is switch the computer on.
It's a match! Well done! What he said was, he said, well, I think I give her a kiss and a cuddle, but Judy will say I switch the computer on.
Well done, first match. Here's your second question. You and David live on the Scottish Borders, where you are exposed to the full force of nature. So which of these weather fronts would you say best sums up David? Would it be a force 10 gale? So sorry, the weather in here is dreadful. Uncontrollable and leaves a trail of destruction. Thunder and lightning. Loud and exciting at first, but gets dull after a while. Like a blanket of snow. Second time around for them. Looks beautiful in the early days, but as time goes on, becomes a bit slushy and dirty. What did he say?
Well, I think he's most like the snow because he's quite peaceful, but he doesn't get slushy and dirty.
Mm-hmm.
He goes on being...
OK. Okay, so would he have said that, do you think?
Yes.
No! Oh. It's not, he said, uncontrollable and leaves a trail of destruction at the first 10 days.
I thought you'd think that about me.
Final question, question three. Judy, you and David love to take part in motor rallies together. David drives and I believe you're the navigator. Imagine this, if you've got totally lost during one such rally, what did David say he would do? Would he pull over into a lay-by and have a blazing row about your navigating? Or would he stop and begrudgingly ask for directions? Or would he kick you out at the local train station and zoom off on his own? Or would he not worry and have a good laugh about it?
He'd not worry and have a good laugh about it.
Yes! Well,
there was no hesitation there.
No hesitation. Well, that was an excellent round, actually. At the end of the booth round, David and Judy got 2 matches out of a possible 3. If you'd like to go and join Keisha and Dean, we'll see you both later for the His and Hers game.
Well done. Thank you.
David and Judy!
Let's meet our final couple tonight. It's actor Sean Williamson and his wife, Melanie.
Sean and Melanie have been married for 12 years. They live in the Kent countryside with their 2 children and menagerie of pets, including alpacas, chickens and canaries.
Oh, hello. What a pleasure to have you here. Welcome, welcome. We'll have a chat in a moment after we've heard what you said about each other.
Here we go.
Myself and Melanie have been together since late 89. We met doing amateur dramatics and it involved a kissing scene, so we got very close very quickly.
When we met, Sean was stacking shelves in a supermarket. I was working, had my own business, had my own recruitment company.
She did have a thriving company, 2 company cars and a nice house.
And he thought, well, I'll have a bit of that.
I think at first we were quite an unlikely couple.
I was just some posh bird, nice calling my little bit of rough.
Yeah. The great thing about Melanie is that she is the DIY person.
He gave me a power drill for my 30th birthday, which is the best ever present.
So you got to go all the way back round this way.
When Sean isn't working, we spend a lot of time together. He plays all sorts of ridiculous games that he's invented for the children.
Mel is the disciplinarian. I really don't like playing bad cop. So I'm definitely Mr. Soft Touch.
Sean said to me when we got together that life would never be dark.
Yeah!
And it hasn't been dark.
We're still together after 20 years, something's working.
But, Melanie, when you first got together with Sean, you actually made a big sacrifice for him, didn't you?
I sold my car and I bought us a karaoke backing system. And we went round pubs and clubs, and he sang and I twiddled the knobs.
Mm. Aye, aye.
So when did you realise that he had a voice that was worth getting rid of your car for?
Second date. He sang in karaoke, took me into a pub and sang, and I thought, went, oh. Aww. And I just love him singing, absolutely love it.
Aww.
So how well do you think you're going to do this evening?
I think we're going to do OK. Melanie's a bit more sceptical, aren't
you? I think we'll probably be the worst contestants you've ever had.
Oh. Well, in fairness to Melanie, she was very nervous about coming on tonight, you know. So she was getting ready, you know, in front of a full-length mirror, and she said, what am I doing going on television?
I did.
You know, going grey, I'm getting old. She said, well, pay me a compliment. I said, there's nothing wrong with your eyesight, love.
The people watching, I'll just feel sorry for him. I'm not hopeful.
I can't wait to see how you do.
I think it's time we started the game. Let's play All-Star Mr. and Mrs. Melanie. You've got to go in the booth first.
Thank
Please,
you.
Off you go. And while you get comfortable, just a reminder that to win the game, it's very simple, Sean. You just have to say the same as you think Melanie's going to say when she comes out. OK. Question one, Sean. You famously played Barry in EastEnders, days ended when Janine pushed you off a cliff.
And she's back and she's still killing people. What's all that about? Is that justice?
Which of these things do you think might lead Melanie to do the same to you? Would it be telling her that you will never sing karaoke again? Or would it be telling her that actually you hate her cats? Or would it be saying that you will never clean the loo again?
Ooh! The cats is an interesting one, because when we got together, I didn't like cats. And then one morning I woke up and there were all of her seven cats on me. Because I had a warm body, so I just had to put up with it, really. And I don't think that'd be a problem, really, because we're overrun with pets, we've got too many. So I'm going to say it's singing karaoke, but I'm not confident on that answer at all.
So
if I said I would never sing again.
If you said you'd never sing again, she'd push you down a cliff and leave you for dead.
Yeah.
Second question. Now, as well as being your wife, Melanie also helps to manage your career.
That's right.
So, imagine Mel becomes your Hollywood agent and lands you a lucrative movie deal.
I'm using my imagination here.
Yeah? Okay. However, on the first day of filming, you have a huge hangover and you can't get out of bed.
Right.
What does Melanie do? Does she cook you a full English and ring in sick, like a good wife should? As your agent, does she force you to get out of bed and go to work? Does she take you off the job and send in one of her other clients because you have blown your chance?
I would say, after a very big earful about self-discipline, it would be B, she just get up, get out and do it.
OK.
I would prefer the first option, the full English on the a day watching this morning, but...
Oh, you're definitely going to win
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I like that. Okay, Sean, final question. You used to be in the Navy. But which seafaring vessel would Melanie say best describes you on the night you first got together? Very specific, this. Here we go. Were you like a submarine? She never knew where you were until your periscope popped up.
Saucy.
Or were you an oil tanker? Full of huge quantities of liquid and difficult to manoeuvre. Because we understand you used to enjoy several pints.
Used to?
Or are you an old sailboat, charming and old-worldly, but takes forever to get going?
I would have to say it's the middle one to do with the oil tanker.
Yes.
Because when I first met Melanie, she said that she'd only ever been in two pubs in her life. And after a month of going out with me, she claimed she'd been in about 25 to 30. It's the truth.
So an oil tanker full of huge quantities of liquid, but difficult to manoeuvre. Yes?
Oh, go on then.
Yep, OK. Thank you very much indeed. Let's see what Melanie thinks. Melanie, please join us.
So just remember now, it is a match that matters.
OK, question one, Melanie. Sean famously played Barry in EastEnders, whose days ended when his wife, Janine, pushed him off a cliff. But which of these things do you think might lead you to do the same to Sean? Would it be if Sean told you he'll never clean the loo again? Would it be if he told you that he hates your cats? Or would it be saying that he'll never sing karaoke again?
Ooh. That's really hard. Oh, it's cats or karaoke.
Really? Did you not know he didn't like cats?
I didn't know he didn't like cats, No. He pretended that he liked cats when we first got together because they used to sleep on the bed. Yeah, I had nine.
We know.
You thought there were only seven.
Good job you didn't ask that question, isn't it?
I'm like two of Hester's. I think I'll have to go with the cats.
Not a match. I'm so sorry. It was apparently if he told you he'd never sing karaoke again, you'd push him off a cliff.
Okay, here's question two. Now, as well as being Sean's wife, you also manage his career. So imagine that you become his Hollywood agent and land him a lucrative Hollywood movie role. However, on the first day of filming, Sean has a huge hangover and can't get out of bed. What do you do? Do you take him off the job and send in one of your other clients because he's blown his chances? As his agent, force him to get out of bed and go to work? Cook him a full English and ring in sick like a good wife should?
Force him to get out of bed and go and do the job.
That's a match! That's a match! Well done.
Final question. Question three. Sean used to be in the Navy, but which seafaring vessel would you say best describes Sean on the night you first got together?
Oh, dear.
Would it be an oil tanker full of huge quantities of liquid and difficult to manoeuvre because of the beer? Or an old sailboat, charming and old-worldly, but takes forever to get going? Or a submarine, because you never quite know where you are until his periscope popped up?
Crikey. First one, I think.
Oil tanker?
Yeah.
It's a match! Three questions, and you've done very well. You've got two matches out of a possible three. So let's hear it for Sean and Melanie.
So, after the first round, it's a three-way tie, but it's early days yet, and it's all to play for. Join us after the break on All Star, Mr. and Mrs.
Still to come.
Who's the best kisser?
Ooh!
You!
Sorry, bitch.
Thanks.
Is it going in the corner of the room?
No.
Yes. Yeah, this is going to go into the corner.
No.
Corner sofa name? Corner has to go
so
in the corner.
So, why put it in the corner?
DFS sponsors All Star Mr. and Mrs.
This high school sing song is not about dreams. There's no cheerleaders or basketball teams. But we've got something that's good for morale. It's Fizzy, it's Ginger, it's phenomenal. We ain't got no one called Jack, Brad or Trey. We don't have haircuts that look like toupees. This juice is class and here's our rationale. It's Fizzy, it's Ginger, it's phenomenal. Break it down. We got no time for American pop, so let's expel it, just give it the chop. Ow! We've got this drink that's from our locale. It's Fizzy, it's Ginger, it's phenomenal. Beat it.
Phenomenal.
Yeah.
A Garnier innovation.
Eyes age in two ways, wrinkles and bags. Now I take double action.
Garnier Ultralift Pro X Double Action Eye. One, the cream reduces the appearance of even deep wrinkles. Two, the refreshing gel targets bags.
Double action, double benefit. Garnier, great innovations, great prices. Take care.
Garnier.
For your chance to win £1,000 before 10 p.m. tonight, tell us. Colleen Nolan features regularly in which daytime show? A. Golden Balls, B. Daily Cook's Challenge, C. Loose Women. Phone 0901-293-1111 or text the word WIN followed by ABOC plus your name and town to 83788. Cost and text cost £1 plus standard network rates.
What sort of thing are you looking for?
We want something really big because we've got three kids. Sorry, four kids.
DFS sponsors All Star Mr. and Mrs.
Welcome back to All Star Mr. and Mrs. So far, we found out Keisha's boyfriend is obsessed with plumping her pillows, Lord Steele flicks on his computer before kissing his wife, and Sean Williamson is a cat magnet. But we've hardly scratched the surface. There's so much more still to come.
We've hardly scratched the sofa, actually. So let's get on with our next game on All Star Mr. and Mrs. So far, we've discovered what our couples know about each other. Now it's time to discover what they really think about each other with the help of the sight-proof screen.
Please welcome back Keisha Buchanan and her partner, Dean Thomas. So there we are, there's Keisha and Dean. They absolutely can't see each other. They each have a set of his and hers paddles, a pink paddle and a blue paddle. We are going to ask them six questions. If the answer is him, then they'll show the blue one. If it's her, then they'll lift up the pink one. To win, they simply have to match their paddles.
For example, if we asked, who's got the biggest feet, how would you answer? You've got it. Yeah. It's that kind of thing. OK.
Question one. Who is the best singer?
Ooh.
This is going to start a feud, you know.
Huh? honestly.
Go for it and don't speak. Yes! It's a match!
Here we go. go. Question two. Who is best behind the wheel? It's a match.
Question three. Who's the best kisser?
Who's the best kisser? Okay.
Ooh!
You!
You
wish!
Sorry, babe.
Thanks.
Question four. Who is most likely to skip morning prayer? It's a match.
Question five. Who eats the most junk food?
What was that? Okay. Oh,
well. Oh, no. No, no match.
Final question in this round. Who is the bigger flirt? Yes, it's a match. Well done. There we are. That is the end of your his and hers round. And you've done well. You've got four matches out of a possible six. Is that going to be good enough, though, to get them through to the final? Well, we'll find out later. In the meantime, Dean and Keisha, thank you. Off you go.
The sight booth screen is Lord David Steele and his wife Judy. Good luck to both of you. Can't see each other?
Nope.
Here are your his and hers questions. Question one. Who's the most annoying in bed? Snoring. Yes.
Question two. Who is most likely to complain in a restaurant? It's a match.
Question three. Who is the most romantic? Oh, no match.
Question four. Who makes the best cup of coffee? It's a match.
Question five. Who would look best in a kilt? That's a match.
And final question, question six. Who would make the best Prime Minister? In the his and hers round, David and Judy have five matches. Congratulations. Thank you. David and Judy.
As they leave, let's welcome back Sean and Melanie. So, paddles in hand, if you're ready, here are your his and hers questions. Question one. Who has the most important job? It's a match.
Question two. Who's most likely to forget an anniversary? Ooh, it's a match.
Question three. Who knows the most? No hesitation. It's a match.
Question four. Who is the most embarrassing parent?
Hmm. We're both pretty good.
No.
Melanie? It's a match!
Question five. Who is the most likely to be seen wearing a shell suit? Oh, no.
Final question in this round. Who is the scariest when angry? Well done, though. In your his and hers round, you got four matches. Congratulations. So, it's now time to reveal to our couples which one of them has made it through to tonight's final. Let's welcome them all back.
Couples have let us peek behind the mask of their marriage, but only one of them can win. The couple who match the most answers and who are going through to the final of All-Star Mr. and Mrs. tonight are Lord and Lady Steele.
Hooray!
And for the first time round, You get 7. So well done. Congratulations.
But we do have commiserations for you, Sean and Melanie, and Dean and Keisha as well. But nobody goes away empty-handed. We're going to give each couple £5,000 each for their chosen charities. And your charity is?
It's called Tommy's Chances. It's for providing educational aids for autistic children and young adults.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. And Dean and Keisha?
The charity that we've chosen is ACLT. It's the African Caribbean Leukemia Trust. And it's really close to our hearts.
Wow. Good. Thank you.
Very good. Well, that's not all they get, because they also get to take home their very own crystal-encrusted all-star Mr. and Mrs. Carriage Clock. Here it is. Look. Absolutely beautiful. And here they are. Right now. Parallel universe, there's a tiny Philip Schofield handing over a massive Mr. and Mrs. Clock. There you are. You're very welcome. Let's hear it for our two departing couples.
And our major congratulations to Lord and Lady Steele. Brilliant. Break, they will be playing for a possible £30,000 jackpot. But first, it's your chance at home to win £5,000 in tonight's viewer competition. We're going to ask you a question now about Joe Calzaghe in this all-star Mr. and Mrs. clip, so you need to watch very carefully.
I met Joe nearly 4 years ago in London at the gym. She's very supportive in what I do, being a boxer. You know, you have a lot of mood swings.
Can be a bit grumpy sometimes.
You know, I think it takes a special sort of person to put up with a lot of things you have to put up with.
What colour boxing gloves was Joe Calzaghe wearing? A. Red, B. Green, or C. Pink? Call 0904 9596 777. Calls cost £1 from BT Landlines. Calls from other networks may be higher and from mobiles will be considerably more. Or text A, B or C as your answer to 60331. Texts cost £1 plus one standard network rate message. Sky or Virgin Media viewers can enter by pressing their red button or enter online for free at itv.com. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 4:30 p.m. on Saturday, so best of luck. Entries made after the closing time will not be counted but may still be charged.
Welcome back to the final of All Star Mr. and Mrs. David and Judy are about to play for a possible £30,000.
Yep, it's time to find out if they actually know each other as well as they think they do. And David, this time it's your turn in the booth.
Thank you.
You know what to do. Get yourself comfortable.
We are going to ask Judy 4 questions, and they're all very straightforward. They're things that every couple should know about their other half, but very often don't. It's not as simple as it looks. The first 3 questions will be about David and will be worth £5,000 for each correct answer. The 4th will be about Judy, and if David gets it right, we will double the money they've earned so far. Are you ready? Good.
Question 1, Judy. What was David's nickname when he first entered Parliament?
Boy David.
Boy David. Thank you.
Question 2. Of all the wine-producing countries of the world, which is David's favourite?
France.
OK.
Question 3. What was David's first car?
Oh, it was an old, beat-up... I don't know what cars, different makes of car are, but it was one that used to be used as a hen coop. And he drove it when he was a beater on a grouse moor when he was a schoolboy. I don't know the make of it, I'm sorry.
Was that his first car?
That was his first car.
He owned it?
He owned it with a friend. They bought it for a fiver.
OK.
And I don't think it was worth that much. Or maybe it was 15 quid. It wasn't very much, anyway.
Are you going to give a stab at a make for that one?
God. I think it might have been a Morris. I think it might have been a Morris.
All right. OK. Here's the fourth question. So this is about you, Judy. Remember, if David matches this, we will double whatever money you've won so far. Mm-hmm. What is your favourite newspaper?
The Herald.
OK.
Lovely. Thank you very much. We have all your answers. Let's release David from the booth. David, come and join us.
We've just asked Judy three questions about David. Those questions are worth £5,000 each. So let's see what Judy knows about David.
Question one. David, this is for £5,000 and here is question one. What was your nickname when you first entered Parliament?
The Boy David.
Correct. £5,000. Well done.
For another £5,000, of all the wine-producing countries of the world, which is your favourite?
France.
Absolutely correct. £10,000.
Question three. For another £5,000, taking your total to £15,000, what was your first car?
A Morris 8.
Oh! Yes, sir!
She knew that?
Well, I would like as well to hear a bit more description, because Judy couldn't... It took her a long time to think of the make.
I bet it did,
but
yeah.
The description, however, was wonderful. How would she have described it?
It was a hen coop. I shared it with a schoolfellow, and we paid, between us, £15. £7.10 each.
There we are. Well done. Thank you. Wow!
Well done. Now, that takes you to £15,000. So we are now playing for the jackpot. That £15,000 is absolutely safe. One more question could double your money to the maximum £30,000 for your chosen charity. So, now we need to know how much you know about Judy. Here is your all-star Mr. and Mrs. double money question. This is for £30,000. I have to take your first answer. What is Judy's favourite newspaper?
She has several. I'll say the Herald.
£30,000! For your charity, you have just hit the jackpot. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And which charity is going to benefit?
It's called the Saga Charitable Trust, and I've just been visiting two of their projects in Kenya last week. One was a children's orphanage, and the other was a primary school library where I laid the foundation stone.
Wow, so that money is going to work very hard.
Money's going straight to the blood stream.
Well, thank you very much indeed. Also, don't forget... Oh, yes, they get to take home the all-star Mr. and Mrs. Carriage Clock as well.
Wanted.
Judy and David, congratulations and very well played.
Thank
and thanks
so
to
much.
All our couples tonight. And we look forward to seeing you soon on All Star Mr. and Mrs. Good night.
Next week on All Star Mr. and Mrs., Andrew Castle and his wife Sophia, Angela Griffin and her husband Jason, and Tito Jackson and his partner Sonia.
Well, coming up next tonight, Chris Tarrant asks the questions in Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Then later on at 9:30, Kenny has a speaking engagement, but will his nerves hold out in Mumbai Calling?